Speech is once gone, gone forever. Once gone, gone forever, youth leader Kripa.
Am I audible at the back?
Yes.
In this technologically advanced world, we can recycle everything. But the only thing which can't be recycled is time. Youth leader of the day, respected Toastmasters, fellow youth leaders, distinguished guests, and little children, very, very warm good afternoon to all of you. It was a warm, sunny morning of April 1999. Monsoon had just ended. There was a festivity in the air, and it peaked the sin of a little angel into this incredible world. I, youth leader Kripa Joshi, was born to Mrs. Vidhu and Mr. Bharat Joshi on 21st April 1999. I feel proud to say that I hail from the land of Mahatma Gandhi and Sardar Patel, which is Gujarat, though I was born in Raipur in Chhattisgarh. My birth was a pleasant shock to my parents. Ask me why? Because I was born 28 days ahead of my scheduled arrival time. My dad says that since childhood, I have always been ahead than the kids of my age. And most times, he had been under stress associated with pleasure. Rare combination, isn't it?
Yes.
Let me elaborate. I was 10.5 kgs when I was merely 11 months old. My relatives and my friends used to appreciate my chubbiness and call me Humpty Dumpty. But my parents, who used to carry me all around, often exclaimed, "Ooh, ah." So it was a pleasure to hear appreciation from others, but stress when they carried me around. My father works as a maintenance leader for Setup. His patience and ability to accommodate more, be it mouth-watering food or anger, has impressed me a lot. His ever-smiling face has been a constant source of motivation for me. My mom, who is a good homemaker, I often see her captivating nuance and grace which fills up the ambience of our home. Tinkering the calmness of our home is my fourth grader naughty sister Sneha, who studies at International Indian School, Al Jubeir. Childhood speaks history in itself. I spent my kindergarten days in Vadodara, Gujarat, and as heard from my parents, I grew up quite being a naughty child until I had someone much more naughtier than me. I had to calm down when my sister made her place into our family. I was the queen of my house and enjoyed full attention of my parents. But when she arrived, she grabbed the attention of my parents and I had to compromise their love and time. When we go to sleep together, she kicks me out of the bed. She takes the maximum share of my favorite food. And for silly reasons, she creates a big drama. Oof, and ultimately I get scolded. But still, she's a favorite of mine. Because as a little baby, she was my first mentor. She taught me how to use time wisely. It was only after her birth that I learned to do all my jobs independently. And when one does his job independently, he does it more effectively, right? When I was 6 years old, we went to Jamnagar, Gujarat. I completed my primary school in SR Nand Vidyaniketan. Schooling has been an enjoyable journey with tons and tons of unforgettable memories. I landed here out in Jubeir when I was in 7th standard. Currently, I'm a 10th grader studying at International Indian School, Al Jubeir. I love singing and playing keyboard, but my ambition is to become an engineer. So dear youth leaders, through this journey of my life from childhood to teenage, I have realized that time is the best resource approachable. Time is the best teacher available. Time is the fondest memory cherishable. But time once gone is gone forever. So friends, time is like a race. Try to win this race. If you spend it in sleep, it will definitely make you weak. Over to you, youth leader of the day.